morning, Prairie Chase Hawks. My name is Reedy.
And I'm Devika. Today is March 24th, and welcome to WPTE. It has been another amazing week on the prairie.
I agree. There's always so many exciting events around every corner. Devika, I have a joke for you.
Okay, let's hear it.
What do you get when you cross a snake and a pie?
I don't know. What?
A python.
Ha ha. Good one, Reedy. I like to see a snake eating a pie.
Speaking of food, let's see what's on the lunch menu today.
For hot lunch, we will have personal pan pizza.
For sandwich, chicken tender wrap.
For salad, we will have popcorn chicken salad.
We also have birthdays to celebrate today. Happy birthday to Cassie Lemmy.
Go down to the office and get your birthday treats. Let's hope those birthdays have nice weather this weekend.
Mikhail is up with this weekend's forecast.
Mikhail, take it away.
Thank you, Reedy and Devika. Welcome to PTE weather forecast for this weekend. I'm Mikhail, and we finally have some good weather news. This past Monday was the first day of spring. Spring is a season of change, and this weekend we are going to see a definite change this weekend. Above average temperatures are heading our way into next week. The highs will be well into the 60s, but before we pull out the summer gear, rain is likely on Saturday and Sunday. We will take the good weather temperatures with the rain. Stay dry, Prairie Chase. Back to the studio.
I'll take the warm weather, even with a chance of rain.
With the chance of rain, it'll be easier to stay inside and watch basketball. Kaden is standing by with this weekend's lineup.
Kaden, take it away.
Thanks, Reedy and Devika. Hi, I'm Kaden Hutzel with this weekend's sports report. We have basketball and then some more basketball. How is your bracket after last night's games? Tonight we will find out who the remaining teams are in the Elite Eight. Butler faces number one seed North Carolina. Let's go, Dogs! Now back to Reedy and Devika in the studio.
Boy, looks like we'll have some good matchups this week.
Good luck to all our Indiana teams.
The odds of filling out a perfect bracket are 1 in a quintillion.
I didn't know that, but did you know that Logan and Nathan are standing by with Did You Know?
No, but now I do.
Logan and Nathan,
take it away.
Thank you, Reedy and Devika. I'm Logan Heisler.
And I'm Nathan Fitzane.
And we're here with Did You Know?
Logan, did you know that cats sleep 66% of their life?
No, but did you know crocodiles never outgrow their enclosure?
No. Did you know that cows have no upper teeth?
No, but did you know that cats can't move their jaws sideways?
No, but did you know that elephants are the only mammals that can't jump?
If you didn't know these facts, now you do. Now back to Reedy and Devika in the studio.
Sometimes I feel like a cat. I like to sleep.
Olivia is standing by with Mrs. Ringenberg with Pets on the Prairie. Olivia, take it away.
Thank you, Devika and Reedy. Hi, I'm Olivia Gardner with your week's Pets on the Prairie. And today's guest is Miss Ringenberg from Miss Dillon's class. Thank you for being here with us today.
Thanks, Olivia.
Miss Ringenberg, what kind of pets do you have?
I have 2 golden retrievers.
When did you get your pets and where did you get them?
Well, I have 2 boys. I have Griffey is 12 and Pal is 4, so 12 and 4 years ago. And they both came from the same breeder in Indianapolis. And an interesting fact about that is Griffey is Pal's uncle.
That's amazing. Can Pal and Griffey do any tricks?
Yes. Lots of tricks. Probably don't have enough time to go into all of them, but they like to sing when I play the harmonica. I'm not a good harmonica player, but whenever they hear a harmonica, Griffey, the older one, starts to howl, and then Pal will start to howl too. And Pal is just a very silly dog. He likes to sit up on his hind legs and bark for treats. And Griffey is just, he doesn't really do a lot of tricks, but he's just kind of, I call him my Velcro dog. He's always next to me. And like if I get startled, if I'm watching a movie and I get frightened, he comes right over to me because he knows that something's wrong with me. So he's a great boy to have.
I wish I had a dog like that. If you could have any pet, what would it be?
Golden Retriever, of course.
You really like Golden Retrievers then?
Love them. Anybody that knows me, from Mrs. Broughton's class to Mrs. Dillon's class to staff, if they know me enough, I love my dogs and I can talk about them all day long.
What are some things that Pal and Griffey like to do?
Pal goes to day camp on Mondays, and it's called Club K9, and he has a lot of friends there that he likes to play with, especially a yellow lab named Hank. And usually when we get close to Club K9, because we always leave the window cracked in the back, Pal hangs his head out the window and he starts to whine because he knows he's getting close to being at camp. So Pal goes to camp, and Griffey, being 12, he just likes to hang out around the house.
Thank you for sharing with us today. Now back to Davica and Reedy in the studio.
Who let the dogs out?
Was nice, the party was pumping.
Hey-ya.
And everybody having a ball.
Ha, ha.
Until the fellas started name calling. And the girls respond to the call. Ha, ha, I have a pull my shout ha, out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
I see the dance people had a ball, cause Billy Bondes get out. Get back, Gruffy, bass Gruffy, get back, you flea infesting mongrel.
Dogs like music so much, they make beautiful music together.
Emmanuel and Wyatt are up next with National Days. Take it away.
Thank you, Reedy and Davica. My name is Emmanuel Carrillo.
And I'm Wyatt Griffith.
And we are here for National Day. Today is Chocolate Covered Raisins Day.
Nice, I have some for lunch today.
Chocolate covered raisins are the third largest selling candy in the United States.
When you combine the raisins with dark chocolate, you have a great tasting healthy snack. Yesterday was National Puppy Day. Even though it was yesterday, who doesn't love adorable puppies?
Nice, I like puppies. They are cute. Thank you for being with us for National Day.
Now back to Reedy and Davica in the studio.
I love chocolate covered raisins. Now that I know they're a healthy snack, I'm gonna eat more.
Good idea. Up next is Lost and Found.
Take it away.
Thank you, Reedy and Davica.
I'm Saswan.
And I'm Ella, and welcome to Lost and Found.
Today we have a black lunchbox that is lost and lonely and would love to join you back on the lunch table.
You can't eat your lunch without a lunchbox. It even looks like it has a juice box in there too. There is also a pink jacket that would be perfect for spring weather.
My sister has a pink jacket that she loves to wear. Football season will be here before you know it. You don't want to be without your Colts sweater.
I have a good feeling about the Colts season this year. There is also a navy blue stylish vest that would be great for wearing this spring.
Next, I have a blue coat that feels cozy. You need to retrieve this to wear outside. The weather has been changing from hot to cold lately.
Finally, we have a math pentathlon shirt.
You worked hard for this shirt to do the math. Come pick up your shirt.
If you are missing any of your belongings, be sure to pick them up in the cafeteria.
Now back to the studio.
There are a lot of nice things that need to be found.
Yeah, look through the bin before we leave for spring break. 7 days till spring break.
Let the countdown begin. Up next is Max with John David Anderson.
Take it away.
Thank you, Reedy and Davica. I'm here with John David Anderson. Do you have any suggestions to become a writer?
Yeah, I have a ton of suggestions to become a better writer. I'd say the first thing that you gotta do is read as much as possible. Read as many different kinds of things as possible. Read the backs of cereal boxes, read novels, read graphic novels, read short stories, read plays, read film scripts, read whatever it is that floats your boat, because anybody who is using language will teach you something about what they've done. And then, once you've read it all, Once you write it all, then you just gotta practice it, right? So you write as much as possible. You keep a journal, or you write short stories to share with your friends, or you write poetry. Doesn't matter what it is, again, as long as you're just constantly immersing yourself in language and using language and putting words together in new and exciting ways, then you're gonna learn a lot more about writing than, say, taking a class or even talking to another author, right?
And yeah.
Practice makes perfect.
What do you think makes a good story?
Take your hero, put them in a bind. And then when they get out of that bind, put them in a bigger bind. And then when they get out of that, attack them with aliens and killer robots and anything you can possibly imagine. Make them be suffering through problems with their parents and their boyfriend or their girlfriend or their dog died or whatever it is, because all good writing is about conflict and overcoming that conflict. And so, for example, my novel Psychicked starts with the protagonist dangling above a pool of acid, right? Get them in trouble right from the start, and then keep them in trouble until they figure out a way out of it.
What are some of your favorite children books and authors in your growing up now and then?
So when I was growing up, I really loved what was called the Prydain Chronicles, which was by Lloyd Alexander, and it was a fantasy series. There weren't quite as many fantasy series for me as there are for you guys, right? You had C.S. Lewis, Chronicles of Narnia, right? And you had J.R. Tolkien, and you had the Prydain Chronicles. And I love the Prydain Chronicles just because they were really funny, and they had characters like Flutterer Flam, who was just completely silly and obnoxious. And my writing now tends to be silly and obnoxious as a result of that. And I loved Winnie the Pooh, and Nate the Great, Dr. Seuss, Fox and Socks, Chicks with Bricks Come, Chicks with Blocks Come, Chicks with Bricks and Blocks and Clocks Come. I love all that stuff. So I had a lot of passions, probably, as a reader, young reader.
As a child, what did you want to do when you were growing up?
I definitely wanted to be Indiana Jones. He had a cool jacket, and he had an awesome hat, and a whip, and he was kind of my hero. And then I figured out that archaeologists pretty much lived boring lives, where they spent all their time in the library. And so then I transitioned to Han Solo until I figured out that there were no space pirates. And so then after that, you know, I didn't know really what I wanted to be. Maybe a scientist, maybe a doctor, until a teacher said that maybe I had a little bit of talent for writing. And that kind of put the little bug in my ear that maybe I could grow up and do that someday.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Nice. Thank you.
Thank you. It was nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you too. Now back to the studio.
I really enjoyed listening to Mr. Anderson yesterday. He had so many interesting stories.
Yes, he did. I look forward to reading his books.
Sophia is up next with Teacher Feature. Take it away.
Go. Hi, I'm Sophia Chimansky with my amazing teacher, Miss Gerner. Thanks for joining me here with Teacher Feature.
Thanks for having me.
So, Miss Gerner, how long have you been teaching?
I've been teaching for about 2 years now, and I love Prairie Trace.
Great. What grades have you taught?
Let's see. In the summer, I taught third grade. I student taught fourth grade, and last year, I taught third grade in IPS.
Wow, that's a lot of grades. What's your favorite color?
Well, as most of my students notice from my room, my favorite color is turquoise.
That's a great color. What are your hobbies?
I love being outdoors. I like to go boxing. I tell my kids to beware. I'm kidding. Love to pet dogs. Even though I don't have one, I have a fish.
Thanks for sharing with us. Now back to the studio.
Ms. Gerner has been an amazing teacher. She's so fun.
It has been a perfect fifth grade year with a perfect teacher.
That concludes this edition of WPTE.
We will end with the Pledge of Allegiance,
Leadership Pledge, and a moment of silence. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you on the prairie.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I pledge, as a Prairie Trace Elementary leader, to have a positive attitude each day. I will make good choices even when no one is looking. I will demonstrate the seven habits by making myself and my school an amazing place.
How much is that doggy in the window? tell. How much is that doggy in the window?